In this video, I'm going to be finishing the Multiplying Rational Expressions worksheet on the CUDA software website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section, picking up where we left off with number 22. Now remember, first we're going to be simplifying each of the rationals in order to solve. So in this first fraction, the numerator, I can pull out a 5. So I'll have 5 times the quantity r plus 10, because 5 times r is 5r, and 5 times 10 is 50, and that's all over r plus 10. So that first fraction will get multiplied to the second fraction of r minus 2 over 5. So you can see that in my numerator I have a 5, and in my denominator I have a 5, so those will cancel out. And when I simplified, I got r plus 10, and that quantity is already in the denominator, so that will also cancel out to equal 1. So I'll have 1 times r minus 2, which is equal to r minus 2. So r minus 2 is my solution in number 22. In number 23, I'm going to simplify both fractions. In the numerator of the first fraction, I'll be able to factor. I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me 25 and add to give me negative 10. The factors of 25 will be 5 and 5, where both of those 5s are negative. So for the numerator, I'll have x minus 5 times x minus 5. And in the denominator, I'll go ahead and pull out a 10 from each of the terms. So I'll have 10 times x minus 10, because 10x is equal to 10 times x, and 100 is equal to 10 times 10, and that 100 is indeed subtracted. Now, I'll multiply that to my numerator over my denominator of my other fraction. So my numerator, I'll leave as x minus 10, and my denominator, I'll be able to pull out a 9. However, if I pull out just a 9, I'll get 9 times 5 minus x. But I want 5 minus x to be in the form of x minus 5. So as opposed to pulling out a positive 9, I'll just pull out a negative 9. Pulling out a negative 9, negative 9 times negative 5 gives me positive 45, and then I'll be adding that x as opposed to subtracting it. So then I can rewrite inside those parentheses, since addition is commutative, so I'll have negative 9 times x minus 5, and that's the factored form of 45 minus 9x. So writing that as negative 9 times x minus 5, I'll be able to cancel out an x minus 5, and I'll also be able to cancel out an x minus 10. So remembering my negative, pulling it out in front, I'll have negative x minus 5 over 9 times 10, which is 90. Keeping this x minus 5 in parentheses, I'll have negative x minus 5 over 90. And again, that's because I pulled the negative out in front. All I have in my numerator is the quantity x minus 5, and my denominator, I multiplied 10 to 9. So negative x minus 5 over 90. Continuing on to number 24, I'll start by rewriting this first fraction because I cannot simplify it any further. So I'll have 45x squared over x minus 9. Now for my second fraction, I can factor that numerator. I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me negative 36 and add to give me negative 5. And that will be 9 and 4, or 4 and 9, where the 9 is negative, because negative 9 times 4 is indeed negative 36, and negative 9 plus 4 is negative 5. So rewriting the numerator as x minus 9 times x plus 4, now I'll rewrite the denominator, pulling out an x squared, since x squared goes into x squared and x to the third, and also pulling out a 3, since 3 goes into 3 and 12. So pulling out 3x squared, I'll have x plus 4, because 3x squared times x is 3x cubed, and 3x squared times 4 is 12x squared. And in doing that, I'll be able to cancel out a lot of my terms. X squared will get canceled out with x squared in the denominator, x minus 9 will get canceled out with x minus 9 in the denominator, and x plus 4 will get canceled out with x plus 4. So all I have remaining is 45 in the numerator and 3 in the denominator. So that's 45 over 3, which 45 divided by 3 simplifies to a positive 15. So 15 is my solution in number 24. In number 25, I can simplify this first fraction by pulling out an 8 from each of those terms. Pulling out an 8 in the numerator, I'll have v minus 7 as the quantity 8 is multiplied by, and pulling out an 8 in the denominator, I'll get v plus 6. So 8 times v minus 7 over 8 times v plus 6 will be multiplied by, simplifying the second fraction, I'll factor v squared plus 9v plus 18. The two numbers that multiply to give me 18 and add to give me 9 are 3 and 6. 3 times 6 is 18, and 3 plus 6 is 9. So I'll rewrite that numerator. So that will be v plus 3 times v plus 6, all over, pulling out an 8v from each of the terms in my denominator, I'll have v plus 3. And that's because 8v times v is 8v squared, and 8v times 3 is 24v. Now, canceling out my terms, 8 divided by 8 is 1, v plus 6 divided by v plus 6 is 1, v plus 3 divided by v plus 3 is 1. So the quantity that's left in my numerator is v minus 7, and the quantity that's left in my denominator is 8v. So multiplying that out, I'll have v minus 7 over 8v. That's my solution in number 25. Now in number 26, right away, I can see that I have 9r cubed minus 54r squared in both my numerator and in my denominator. So those two binomials will cancel each other out. So I'll have 9r squared plus 9r divided by 9r squared plus 45r. Now I'm going to simplify both my numerator and denominator in order to solve. Pulling out a 9 from each of the terms in my numerator and an r, 9r times r plus 1 is equivalent to 9r squared plus 9r. And then pulling out a 9r in my denominator, that'll leave me with r plus 5, because 9r times r plus 5 is 9r squared plus 45r. So now I can cancel out my 9r, because 9r divided by 9r is 1. So that will leave me with r plus 1 over r plus 5. That is my solution in number 26. On to number 27. For simplifying my first fraction, I'll have m plus 1 over, pulling out a 3 because 3 goes into 3 and 15 evenly, that'll be 3 times m minus 5. Now simplifying my second fraction, I can pull out an 8 in my numerator to get m minus 10, because 8 times m is 8m, and 8 times 10 is 80. And then in my denominator, I need to factor m squared minus 9m minus 10. So I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me negative 10 and add to give me negative 9. And the factors of 10 that will add to give me negative 9 will be 1 and negative 10. Because 1 times negative 10 is negative 10, and 1 plus negative 10 is negative 9. So I'll rewrite my denominator in my second fraction as m plus 1 times m minus 10. So you can see that m plus 1 will cancel out because it's in both the numerator and denominator, and so will m minus 10. That leaves me with 8 in the numerator and 3 times m minus 5 in the denominator. So 8 over 3 times m minus 5 is my solution in number 27. Now lastly in this video, I'll be working through number 28. Right away, I can see that 6n plus 6 divided by 6n plus 6 will equal 1. So my numerator of one fraction will cancel out my denominator of the other fraction. So I will have n squared plus 6n minus 27 all over n plus 9. Simplifying, I'm going to see what two numbers multiply to give me negative 27 and add to give me a positive 6. And the factors of 27 will be 3 and 9, where that 3 is negative, because negative 3 times 9 is negative 27, and negative 3 plus 9 is a positive 6. So I'll have n minus 3 times n plus 9. And that's all over n plus 9. And my n plus 9 divided by n plus 9 will equal 1. So I'll have n minus 3 times 1, which is simply n minus 3. N minus 3 is my final solution on this worksheet. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask them in the comments below. Also, if you want to just leave me a note, put that in the comments below as well. Also, all likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and just show me that you're finding these videos useful, which in turn encourages me to come out with more videos for you. So go ahead and do that now. So once again, thank you for your support.